Hey there, CPO here, and I want to give you a quick video giving some tips on installing a car camera. This is a pretty typical car camera you might find on eBay or Amazon. It's a CCD camera with supposedly an IP68 rating, meaning it's waterproof, but at any rate, this is a pretty typical example of what you're going to get when you buy car cameras. Now, I did put my magnet mount on there, basically epoxied magnets to the bottom of this to make it magnetic. That's a whole different video, actually, I've already published. But I want to talk a little bit about the wiring. So normally what you'll have is a video RCA and then some sort of a power pigtail. And then that's what this is for. The power will plug into here to give it 12 volt positive and then the ground. And then you'll have this long, usually a cable that will allow you to get your video feed out. Now, a lot of people ask me questions about how I wire these. So I thought I would do a quick tip video because I'm getting ready to go out and throw this one into the Jeep. So first of all, you have a couple of options, which is really cool. So if you have a power source close to where you're putting the camera, you can just tie this pigtail straight into that power source. So depending on where you're getting your 12 volt power, you can find power and ground near the camera and then just use this and then run this video feed separately. But what you do see is on the video feed, they happen to have these little red tails. What those are for is actually, it's a convenient way to run power to your camera along with the video feed. So the video feed has its normal cable, but there also is a separate power line that can be fed through there. And that's how I'm gonna wire this one up. So what that means is, this red power wire off the pigtail can basically get connected to the red that's plugging into the video feed. So this makes this a nice, you can obviously cut this to length, which I usually do, a nice compact setup. So red to red there. So red, I just cut this pretty short and we'll attach that to the red here. And then on the other side, the side that's gonna plug into where my video viewer is, in this case, my head unit, I have a 12 volt power source that this will tie into. So basically I'm feeding 12 volt power all the way through this long cable, all the way, hits the pigtail, goes into the camera. So that's how I wire that. Just thought I would share that little tip with you because I think a lot of people are confused when they see this red pigtail. Number one, can they use it for power? And the answer is yes. Number two, what do you do about the ground? So I was always originally under the perception that you had to have this ground connected. So if you ran your power, even through the AV pigtail here, you had to still connect ground to something local. But I learned accidentally, actually, because I had a tipper, I was doing some temporary wiring just to test the camera position. So I had a temporary ground sort of tied around a post that gave me ground. And then that fell off while I was in the middle of testing and the camera still worked. And I was like, oh, duh. So what I realized is that the ground is probably completed through the AV ground, because there's a ground here as well. There's a ground and then the center pin is the signal. So my assumption is that they've somehow electronically connected those grounds. So if you're missing the ground off of this and you're leveraging this, you're good to go. So anyway, just a little side note of something that I learned accidentally. So it makes it a lot easier if I don't have to worry about actually attaching a connection anywhere at the camera position. But with all that said, I'm still gonna probably wanna research to find out if that's the smart thing to do or if it's still better to have a separate ground run. So anyway, thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the next one.